Tyler, can you talk a little bit about the kind of segue for you of being a musician into wanting to make a documentary, into making a film? What was that initiative for you?
I feel like because I'm an artist, I turn to music, I turn to media as a way to express myself. I made an album about my faith crisis last year. It's very direct. Dan has been a friend, and when he had this project, I was in it, in the thick of it, as it was evolving, and it became this beautiful film called Believer, but we didn't know what we were doing when we were doing it, you know, and it evolved, and if you'll see the film, it's just happening in real time. So for me, just seeing it, I've seen it now a few times, even just the Love Loud concert that we were able to pull off, just these have been very healing moments for me personally and my personal story. So I can't imagine what it'll serve to other people, just seeing this represented the way it is. So.
And it's ironic in a strange sense that it's premiering here at Sundance, which is in Utah, which is kind of the home of the Mormon Church. What kind of message do you hope this documentary can kind of put out into the world?
You know, I'll put my personal politics aside for just one second, and I hope that it reaches Mormon people. I hope that because I think Mormon people do feel and are emotionally in tune, I really hope that it speaks to them. But I hope it also makes kids like me who didn't have movies like this feel safe, you know? So it's a lot, and it means a lot, because it's been a real pain in my life, and it's obviously still bugs me. So I really hope that people just see it and understand, because beyond what we believe in, like, the stories we tell are our truth, and that you can't deny. So, yeah.
Just good. Maybe real quick, in a sentence or two, just kind of describe what the documentary is. I mean,
it's basically the story of Dan's faith crisis last year, and his reconciling with faith and sexuality. And I have been a friend of his for a long time, and he saw my pain, and so I am able to tell my story, and able to tell Asia, Dan's wife's story, and then we explore other LGBT youth stories within it, and it all culminates in this beautiful festival that we threw in August down in Provo, Utah, and 20,000 people showed up to an arena, and we tried to bridge a gap, and now we have Love Loud, and it's a foundation, and we're going to do another one, and it's a beautiful thing, and I think this area specifically needs to hear this messaging. So,
last question for you. Just kind of give a state of the union on Neon Trees. I mean, are you guys in the studio recording? What can fans expect next?
Yeah, I took a break and did a solo record, and we've been working on music, and this year we'll put it out, but we're kind of just finishing it. So, yeah, but we're a band, and we're happy. But it took a minute. We all had to, you know, it's complex within my own band. Two of them are still Mormon. Two of us aren't. So there's that dynamic that we're all kind of going through as well. So anyway, it's good.